Shelby County Democratic Party is undergoing a serious makeover.
You may remember they were stripped of their charter last year and disbanded after allegations that former chairman Brian Carson embezzled thousands of dollars. Well, they've now begun the process of trying to get that charter back. Carlissa Shaw and David Cocke are the Shelby County Democratic Party co-chairs. This is a big job upon which your shoulders are resting. We have a series of public meetings starting, and we'll put that information on the screen. But who should come? Just Democrats or anyone interested in the political process?
We're actually welcoming anyone interested in the political process. As people well know, the Democratic Party is the big tent party, and we want to welcome anyone who's interested in Shelby County, in Memphis, in the betterment of our city and our community. We want all those who can come, children, adults, anyone who can come to these meetings.
As you said, a big tent party, but under the tent there had been a number of problems in recent years. Where do we stand there today? What's going to make, David, I guess, this a new party for the people, perhaps?
Well, we have a unique opportunity here. Not many organizations get a chance for an entirely new, fresh start. And there were a number of problems, both structurally and just internal bickering, that we really needed to overcome. And the state party decided to appoint a new special committee, 13-person committee, mm-hmm. of which Clarissa and myself, we are the co-chairs.
Mm-hmm.
We're not the party. We're just here to help reorganize the
to
new
guide
party.
The reorganization. So how have you dealt with, in your 13-person commission, moving forward, avoiding those ego battles, those inner infighting, you know, issues, the public perception that there was corruption? How have you dealt with that?
Well, actually, it's been refreshing. There are so many new people involved in the party these days, motivated a great deal by the Trump presidency. And a lot of organizations are popping up on their own. And our purpose is to try to channel that enthusiasm, rather than dwell on the past, channel that that enthusiasm that's been developing recently, mm-hmm. and make sure we have a stronger party in the future.
Yeah. So at the same time, though, how do you kind of sell this to the public that this is a, again, fresh party here, and that it will not be tainted? Because a lot of people may, you know, they're already apathetic when it comes to politics, and they pull back a lot of times. How do you let them know this is something brand new, and this other part is a part of the past?
Well, I think that the state pulling the charter was a good thing, and understanding that we're restarting from scratch. So a big part of what this ad hoc committee is tasked with doing is restarting the bylaws, relaying the foundation for the entire party. So there are some things that our ad hoc committee have been very intentional about including with this new Shelby County Democratic Party. One thing that I'm very focused on is inclusiveness. So making sure that this party is diverse, not just with race and color, which is an issue that we always talk about,
right.
but with gender and age also. So making sure that we bring out young, new, fresh ideas and fresh faces to be a part of this Democratic Party.
Because sometimes in any organization that's been around a long time, it is sort of a good old boy network, is it not? And the folks who have been around for a long time are always the ones at the top. Are you actively avoiding that?
Well, we're expecting the new party officers and members to be activists, and not just to rely on their title and their influence.
Or their parents,
or their
activity
exactly,
in the party.
Or their own past activity. Mm-hmm. We're focused on making sure that everybody who is involved in this party works for the party. Mm-hmm. We've underperformed in countywide elections. We know that for a number of years. There are some House districts out there that we haven't put even a candidate in place in 20 years.
Wow.
Now, in House District 95, you can see the enthusiasm. Win, lose, or draw, it is magnificent to see the number of Democrats who are involved in that race out in the country.
Instead of just saying, we'll never win that one.
Carlissa, exactly. How personal is this for you, though, riding this ship?
It's extremely personal for me. I'm a lifelong Miffian, and so I'm vested in the life of this community. And I strongly believe that in order for Memphis to be successful, we have to have a thriving Shelby County Democratic Party. Mm-hmm. We have to locate and identify those people who are intentional and interested in making sure that Memphis is great, and making sure that they have the support and that they are supported by the Democratic Party and elected. And once we get those people elected, making sure that they're held accountable and making this city great again.
All right, we'll definitely be watching
from
for
the
sure.
public. Right. And you'll do that starting tomorrow.
We appreciate you all being here today.
Appreciate
Thank you very
it.
Much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Our